All right, guys, we are doing event 5 from the 2018 CrossFit Regionals. Boom, boom. All right, so obviously, if you don't start the workout off with a tuck and roll, you're not really starting a workout. Let's be real with ourselves. So in the day, in the course of doing all these regional workouts in the same day, this would be, for me, I believe, event number 4. I started out with event number 3. I then did event 2. I did event 1. And I think I rested like 30 minutes after event 1 to knock this out because I was running out of time in the day and honestly running out of gas. All right, so first off, let's talk about the workout description. Of course, this is a 17-minute time cap. This workout is for time. The workout description is 50 handstand push-ups, 50 toes to the bar, 50 calorie assault bike, 50 box step overs over a 24-inch box with 270-pound dumbbells in your hands, and then a 50-foot overhead walking lunge, and then another 50-foot overhead walking lunge, and each lunge is a little bit different. One lunge has one in the front rack and the other overhead with the dumbbells, and then when you get hit 50-foot mark, you switch it and do the other side. So the best definition of this workout, honestly, is it's just a straight grinder, right? Like, there's nothing super skilled about it, right? Like handstand push-ups, as most regional and games athletes, you can knock out huge sets, toes to the bar, huge sets, aerosol bike, you're just doing it, box step overs, you're shutting your brain off and just going. So let's talk about my game plan going into this grinder of a workout for event 5. So contrary to popular belief when it comes to a handstand push-up, I am actually very good at handstand push-ups, especially if they are regional and game standard, which are seriously the easiest standard ever invented to mankind, right? So we've got a 36-inch wide box and a 24-inch deep box, and essentially you can't have your fingertips. You can have your fingertips outside the box, but your palms can't be, so the meat of your hands have to stay inside the box. Super easy standard, especially when it's compared side-by-side with a measure your forearm length, divide by 2, sine over cosine equals tangent, and then that's the height of your heel location for handstand push-ups. But we're not here to rant about that, so I digress. So let's talk about how I've done it so far. Up to this point, I believe I did all my 50 handstand push-ups unbroken. Seriously, 50 handstand push-ups are not hard to do unbroken. You're a little bit gassed, but how much time do you really save by getting off? It's really quite simple. I believe my toes the bar, I'm going to do 2 or 3 sets. So I'm going to start off with 25 to 30 reps. Really not that hard. You really have to be somewhat careful when it comes to the toes the bar, because if you really, really go out for a large set and you're not used to it, you could wreck your grip, and your grip will definitely be a factor in the fourth movement. Really, guys, honestly, when it comes to this workout, I'm just going to kind of fast forward and do some more voiceover once we get to the box step overs. There's really nothing to talk about here. It's basic toes to bar. I'm going to get on the bike. I'm going to hold a 70 to 72 RPMs, really basic pace. I'm not going to blow a red line. I'm not going to blow the gasket in red line. You did see some guys do that, and I'll talk about that at the end. All right, so we're done with the bike at approximately 7 minutes. What we've got left is 50 box step overs and 100-foot lunge in 2 50-foot increments, right? So this is the point of the workout that is the meat and potatoes. This is the part that actually matters, right? So handstand push-ups, easy. Toes to bar, easy. Bike, keep it easy. Box step overs, the hard part, right? It's the shut off your brain and let's get going. So just like regional standard, I'll be doing 6 box step overs on this box. I'll then lay my dumbbells down and advance my box like I'm doing right now into the next 6 rep increment portion. My strategy going into these box step overs, I mean, as much strategy as you can create, right? I mean, it's box step overs. It's like straight grunt work. There's not really a whole strategy to it, but if I could say there is one, it would be, hey, I'm not going to break inside my sets, right? So if I'm going to do 6, I'm going to do all stinking 6. I'm not going to do 4, set it down, rest and do 2. I can easily rest when I'm moving my box. And I think as you watch the regionals go on, you'll have seen the guys that did very well do that. You tend to waste a lot of time if you don't finish all 6, you get 5, or you get 4, and you decide to set them down, because now you're just killing time and you're just watching that time fly by. Hope you guys enjoy the rest of the workout. It's a straight grinder. It's a great workout. I loved it. I think it was very well programmed. I don't understand why more people didn't finish it. I didn't think it was that hard of a workout per se. I think what most people ran into is they started out too hot. They thought to themselves, oh, 50 handstand pushes, 50 toes bar, 50 bike. I can just cruise through this and create as much time as I can on the backside. And really, you should be kind of coasting through the first couple movements, keeping your heart rate low, and then trying to go as fast as you can when it comes to the box step overs, right? So this is my game plan, really quite simple game plan. And then, when it gets to the lunges, you'll see me go unbroken on both sets, down and back, which I think is the only way to go unless you literally just can't hold it overhead and you're falling apart. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. The next event after this that I did was I rested about 20 to 30 minutes, and I knocked out event 6, which would have been the 5th workout of the day. All right, guys, thanks again.